heard on the radio today that a high school in Memphis, 90 girls are purposely pregnant to get on MTV's Teen Mom. 90 wombs are blooming, soiled orchids, pin-pulled, initiated grenades are counting down until atomic explosion underneath their Captain Planet t-shirts that are swelling like a malnourished child's belly in a third world country's sonograms. Desperately clutched to like lottery tickets for their claim to fame, my stomach curdled. The next time an episode found its way to my TV set, and I thought about the next generation of girls preparing for their audition date, and I knew, like a popped cherry, another father's heart is breaking. But this won't feel any better after a few times, as his daughter becomes an additional notch on the bedpost, milk still fresh on her breath, but she got so many handprints on her thighs, you can mistake her for a sidewalk on Hollywood Boulevard any given day. Accidentally fool you for maybe 15 when the sun don't fully advertise that baby face, and you overlook her tissue-stuffed stiletto, seesaw stride, struggling at fulfilling women's shoes, her unbound tear-shaped breast. Slight resemblance of face-down pacifiers poking against her see-through tank top. Have you thinking maybe this was an act of feminism, but it's just she's not old enough to own a bra yet. Nevertheless, you were never mistaken her for untouched. Untouched like the expired condom ruffled in his back pocket he never bothered to open. He cradles her head in the bow of his lap, closes his eyes and concentrates so he can make sure she still makes curfew. If her father knew that there is an army marching, soaking in his daughter's snow-white underwear. There is a battleground nestled in her throat. Like first snowfall of winter, her alabaster-glazed lips will glisten, her chin drizzling like poorly painted walls. She'll wear this like a Purple Heart medal for surviving his unloaded barrel. She sipped. Makes me wish I could ask her, my sister, where has your crown gone? Don't you remember you are royalty? See, the only queen he's used to is the mattress he lays you on. Finger fucking you, you settle for middle and index, disregarding the rest of them boys. Do not pray at your temple anymore. And you kiss. You kiss with the same lips you pray to God with, so he'll never grace his with yours, because you can never be that sacred. Your father asks you if you got your first kiss yet, so he can prepare himself for the day some boy's bee sting turns his little girl into a bird, if he only knew he was asking the wrong questions. See, even if he peeled all those backseat car decals off of your skin, Medusa Glarestone stuck you in that upright position so you could never fall to your knees again for a man, came to terms that his soon little princess will join all the other Susie Q's in abortion clinic lobbies that babysits daughters like an after-school latchkey program. If he could accept that you're only a flick away, exploited like a new age savior crucified against tiny pink crosses, when the news announces it's 10 o'clock, do you know where your children are? Of course he will. MTV is hosting her funeral service on the Tuesday night time slot.